Enots Engineering, I'm Alan. In this week's video, we have another quick tip for the lathe. We'll test a new lever attachment on the cutter grinder by grinding the lathe tool and make some ejection pins for ejecting Morse tapers from the tailstock. And a thanks to David Sanderson, who gave me the idea of using an aluminium bong in the end of the Morse taper. So let's go into the workshop. Today, I'm going to do some modifications to this valving centre and to this centre I use when I'm using a die in a tailstock. So what I want to do on these, this one hasn't got a tang on the end and it's too short. I did show you a way of getting it out with a piece of wood in one of my previous videos. So what I want to do is make something on the end that will automatically eject the centre. And also on this one, I want to drill a hole in the end of this so that the threaded bar will go inside this guide so I can thread a longer length of thread on a bar. Now let's start with this one. First of all, I just want to grind the lathe tool tip. This has been used before. Slight burr on the top. So I'm going to grind this face and the top face to give a nice cutting edge. I've adjusted this to give me the movement just in front of the wheel, so when this is straight the tool is on the centre of the wheel there, so I can move it equal amount each side. And I've adjusted the table, it's set at 6 degrees, so I'm putting a 6 degree angle on the side of the tool. I want the wheel to go that way so that it's pushing down. Bring it in front, feed the tool in, tip it up to have a look. So what I'll do is mark this up with a black felt tip pen so I can see where it's grinding. You can see here it's touching there and down there, but it's not cleaned up the tip yet. You see now it's just clearing up the tip. Cleared up the face. Okay, I've set my table stop there so that will stop.
We're cutting on the other side of the wheel, so I'll need to rotate the wheel in the opposite direction.
Well, that will stop there at that depth. You can see the top face there. The side face. All that's left to be done is this front angle. I've set the tool in the holder now just to grind the other side. As I'm on this side of the wheel, I want the wheels to go that way. The feeder. So you can see now I've cleaned up the three sides. That's ready for the lathe. On the Boxford lathe, when you get the chuck to the right position, you can lock the spindle. This helps when taking the chuck off. So to make it a little easier, if you mark the position
the small file. So you know when this mark is at the top, the spindle lock can be applied. Save you having to turn it round, trying to find where it is. Now the first thing I want to do is turn this down to just over 10 mil. At the moment we've got 20 mil. Engine oil. Ten point two five. I'll leave it at that. So I need to turn the outside down to the outside of this, just under 15 mil. Just take a little bit more off. That should do it. 14.76, that'll be okay, that'll clear that. So now I want to drill a 4 mil hole, tap it 5 mil. Then part it off. Just using the chuck jaw to square this up. Just put a small dish there. Should fit in there. Okay, what I've done now is put the aluminium on the end, 5 millimeter cap head in there, so now I can adjust that in and out. Before, when I put this in, it would lock, and as you come to eject it, I'd have to put a piece of wood behind there. That's because the length of the center was too short. Now when I come to eject it, it touches on that cap head and ejects the center, so I don't need the piece of wood anymore. And that's just putting small aluminium threaded bung in the hole. Use a cap head, then you can extend that with a nut on there. You can extend it until it ejects where you want it to, but in this case it only needed a small amount. I have the same problem with this number two Morse taper. It won't eject, so what I have to do on this one, I have to put some wrench on there, twist it till it comes loose. So on this I'm going to do the same thing, drill and tap a 5mm hole in the end, fit a cap head in there, and I can adjust it in and out until it comes to the right length to eject. I'm going to drill a bigger hole in this end so that as I'm threading a bar I've got some clearance, so I can go up to 2-2.5 inches along the bar. Well, the first job is to put this in the chuck, get this running true, drill and tap 5mm. Just turn it round by hand. This style indicator's in each reading's 0.5 thou, so that's running out about 2 thou. Now, because I want to get some feedback from the amount of force I'm putting on this tap, because it's only a small tap, 5mm, I don't want to snap it off, I've put the tap in a tap holder and a small centre in there which has gone into the back of the tap. So now as I turn the headstock, I can feel if that's getting too tight or not. On this I'm using my expanding mandrel in the headstock, which gives me a hexagon on the end that I can put a spanner on to turn it. It's gone in full depth. See from that, I've not touched the centre, it's still clear, so I can still locate off the centre if I need to. And I've drilled and tapped 5mm in the end. So let's put a cap head in and see if it works. That's tightened up on the thread because I didn't use a bottoming thread, so it's slightly a tapered thread. If it didn't tighten up, you could put a nut on there and use that to adjust the length. But on this, it goes in. And now when I back it off, before I had to get the grips on it to get it out, it's just ejected there. Just drilling a 7mm hole. Mill hole, put a chamfer on the edge, so if I need to I can pick that back up on the centre. That fits in the tailstock. Then this is my die holder which goes on there and travels along this. So now I can get an inch length of thread on the die holder, but now with the hole on there I can then move the tailstock down and go up to 3 inches of thread. Well, that's it today. That's two Morse tapers with ejection pins on the bottom, so I can get those in and out the tailstock easy. And on my die holder I've just drilled out clearance for whatever I'm threading.
Thanks for watching. If you liked it, why not subscribe? And we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.